गुड क्वेश्चन एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज अ बिट ऑफ अ लेंथी क्वेश्चन. ओके सो दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव कंसीडर्ड दिस क्वेश्चन. सो ऑल ऑफ द पॉसिबल सिनेरियोज दैट अकर इन द एल्गोरिथम विल जस्ट गो बाय दिस. ओके सो दिस इज अगेन टी एफ ए एंड द प्रॉब्लम इज द अगेन problem is again to minimize the number of states that are contained in the DFA. Okay, so the again remember the first step is to check, if you remember from the previous lecture, the first step is to check all the states are reachable from Q0. Okay, all the states are reachable from Q0. If they are not reachable, so you delete these states, that states have no meaning to it. Okay, so if I just check it from Q0, okay, so here is Q0. So from Q0 to Q1 I can reach it from getting an input of 0. From Q0 to Q2 I can again reach it. Okay, so from Q0 to Q5 I can also reach it. So Q1, Q2 and Q5 are reachable. After that, can you reach Q4? Q0 to Q5 to Q6 to Q4. Okay, so Q4 is also reachable. In the same way, Q6 is also reachable. I check that Q7 is reachable. Q0 to Q5, 5 to 6. And I don't think you are. Okay, so I can reach. Okay. So Q0 to Q5, Q5 to Q6, Q6 to Q4, and Q4 to Q7. So Q7 is also reachable. Sometime it become very difficult to check, but please perform this step. It is one of the most important steps in this minimization algorithm. Okay. So now the Q1, Q2, Q5, 4, 5, 6, 7. Only Q3 is remaining. So check for Q3, 0, 1, 2. So there I don't think, because there is no arrow going towards Q3. If you check, the arrows are coming out of Q3, but no arrow is leading to this state Q3. Okay, so I know that Q3 is not a reachable state. Okay, so first you do not have to consider this the output or the output of Q3. So Q3 is also is already deleted. So all the states that are reachable from Q0 will be a part of this process. If any state is not reached from the start state, you do not have to include that state. So in this way, now the step one, you realize the significance of step one. So most of the students forget this step and they just draw the transition table and go on forward with that. So please keep this in mind that step one is also a very important step. Okay, so now you know the second step, you just have to draw a transition table. Okay, so transition table is number of states are Q0, Q1, Q2. It's Q3 is not there, so it will be Q4, Q5, Q6 and Q7. Okay, so I just copy the, again you can draw this table from getting an input of 0, from getting an input of 1. Okay, so this is a transition table. So I just have written this, so I just directly copy and pasting this value. Okay, so this is Q1 and Q5. From Q1 it is Q6 and Q2. Then there is Q2, Q0 and Q2. You can check if there is no mistake. I have already written the values here. Q7 and Q5. Okay. So Q2 and Q6. Okay. So Q6 and Q4. Q6 and Q2. Okay. So the final state here is Q2. So keep in mind the final state. So I just write a star here also so that I can keep a track of the final state. Here, if you write this star inside this, if you can again get a very good intuition that something is going to a final state and something is not. So you can directly say that they are not equivalent. Suppose if I have to compare Q2 and Q4 equivalence, I can directly say, because there is a star here, that Q4 and Q2 are not equivalent. Okay. So if I just have to compare like these two, Q4 and Q5, I can see that there is a star here. So this star means that it is always a different set. So you can again directly go from here. Okay. So if you do not write the star, there is nothing wrong about it. Okay. So I just start with the step again. I just verify that there is no mistake here. If there is a little bit of mistake here, it will be very difficult for us. Okay, so I will not be able to just okay. So I think that's like that is correct. Okay. So any of you, if find a mistake, just inform me. I am just continuing with the procedure here. Okay. So you know the procedure. Once this transition table is done, so you can forget about this diagram. Okay. So one and the same thing. We have taken this diagram and transformed into a transition table. Okay. So the first step is zero equivalent by not getting an input of anything, any string. So this is just the two sets of a final and non-final states. Okay. So the final state here is Q2 and the non-final states are Q0, Q1, Q4, Q5, Q6 and Q7. Okay. Okay. So this, if you consider this step one, and this is as set two. Sorry for that. I think there is a bit of processing problem. Okay. So this is your set one and this is your set two. For one equivalent, you have to input something. Okay. So now, you have to check the equivalence property of the various states here. Okay, so I will start with Q0 and Q1. Okay, so start with Q0 and Q1. So Q0 and Q1 is written here. So it belongs to Q1, Q6. So Q1 and Q6 belongs to the same set one. So don't there is no problem about it. After that, there is Q5 and Q2. So Q5 belongs to set 1 and Q2 belongs to set 2. So there is a problem here. Okay. So if you directly look at it, you can again find that there is a star here. So you know that star is already a different set. I can directly recognize. That is why I am saying that again, writing a star here will be helpful and a little bit intuitive. Again, if you do not want to write a star here, you can directly go with it. So there is S1 and S2. It means that Q0 and Q1 cannot be placed together. It means that Q0, I just divide these into different sets. So Q1 has a different set, Q0 has a different set. After that, now I have to check that Q4 is equivalent to Q0 or Q4. So I have to check it. Okay, so if it is equivalent to one, it will not be equivalent to other. So you do not need to check that. But if you still want, for your sake, you can check it. But if it is equivalent to one, it will not be equivalent to other. Okay, so I am just checking Q0 and Q4. On getting an input of A and B here, Q0 is going to Yes. There is any doubt? So if you check is Q1 and Q7 belongs to the same set, that is your set 1, and Q5 and Q5 also belongs to the same set. It means Q0 and Q4 are equivalent and it can be placed in the similar set. Okay, so that is why I'm placing it in a similar set. After that, there is Q5. Now, again, you can check it with Q1. That Q4 can be placed with Q1, but if you check it, the result will be similar, that it cannot be placed here. So you do not have to check that. If it is equivalent to one set, it will not be equivalent to other. Okay, so that is the property here. Again, for your sake, I am just checking to make sure that this is Q1, Q5, and the Q4 here. Q6 and Q2. That is, I think I did something wrong because it should not be together. So Q2 and Q6 and Q2 star, and Q4 here is Q7 and Q5. If you again look at this, there is a star here. It means that it belongs to the set 2, and this Q1 is belong to a set 1. So these on B, you can see that they are going to a different set. It means that Q1 is not equivalent to Q4. Okay. So again, if you check it with one set, you do not need to check with other, it will automatically will not be equal. So the algorithm is designed in such a way. Okay. So check for Q5. Now Q5 can be placed in this set and can be placed in this set. So these two sets are opened here. So I have not closed these sets. So I have to check with both. Okay. So now I just one element is enough to check it. So I just check it with Q0 or Q5. Now Q0 here is Q1, Q5. If you check Q5, again you can see a star here. It means that it is going to a different set. Okay. So on Q5, if you check that this is set 2 and Q1 is set 1. So on getting an input of A, Q0 and Q5 is going to different directions. It means Q0 and Q5 are not equivalent. Okay, so now this Q5, I have to check it that I can place it with Q1 or not. Okay. So to check it with, I place it with Q1, I just go here and just check it for Q5. So Q5 here is Q2 star and Q6. Okay, so I think it is in this here again, this is not, will not be the same here. So on Q1, it is going towards Q6, which belongs to set 1 and Q2 star belongs to set 2. It means that Q1 and Q5 is not again equivalent here. So I have to open a new set here that is called your Q5. So it is not equal to this set as well. It is not equal to this set. So I have to open a new set. Now for Q6, I have to check these three sets also. Okay. So for starting with this Q0 and Q6. So I just check it with Q0 and Q6 here. So for Q6 here, it is Q6 and Q4. Okay. So I don't think there is any problem because there is no star here. So I don't think that they will be equivalent in a way. Okay. So if you check it again, Q0 on Q1 belongs to set 1. Q6 also belongs to set 1. So on A, it is going towards the same set. So no problem here. On Q5, it belongs to set 1. On Q4, it also belongs to set 1. Okay. If you check it, Q4 is in set 1. Okay. So it means that Q0 and Q6 are equivalent. So just place the Q6 here. After that, only Q7 is remaining. So again, I will go with the first set. I will check Q7 here. Okay. So Q7 here is Q6 and Q6, Q2 star. Okay. So for the star, you can again see that on B here, if you check that Q2 star belongs to set 2. Okay. So on B here, Q0 is going to two different sets. So it means that the Q0 and Q7 are not equivalent. So again, I have to check with Q1. Okay, so Q1, if I just check it with Q1, so Q1 here is Q6 as well as Q6 and Q2. Okay, so if you check Q6 and Q6 is one and the same set, and Q2 and Q2 is again one and the same set. Okay, so it means that they are both going to the similar set on getting an input of A and input of B here. Okay. So it means that Q1 and Q7 are equivalent to each other. So I can place Q7 here. Okay. So after that, every set is completed. So you can again copy and paste this set. So keep in mind that our main goal is if there are two or three elements in the set, I will try to break this into different set. Okay. So if an element is only containing one element, I cannot break this set further. Only if it is containing only one element, I just copy and paste this set in every equivalent scenario. Okay, so Q2 is only a one set. I cannot break it further. So there is no need. There is no need. I am repeating this. It is an important step. There is no need to check its equivalence with these set. Okay. So Q0 is already a different set. Only the equivalence can be checked within the set. Within the set. Okay. So Q2 is only one element. So you cannot check the equivalence with any set. Okay. So that is why I just copy and pasted this as same as this. Okay. Again, in the third step, I cannot do anything about this Q5. It is again a lone element in the set. So you do not need to do anything for these two sets. I just try to break these two and break these two. Okay. So break this three. So our main focus is only on these two sets. Okay. So just keep in mind that our algorithm is only based on where the elements in a set are more than one. Okay. So I think you got some bits of it. Okay. So for two equivalent, now there are three sets. So there is a better possibility. There are four sets. So there is a better possibility of breaking this set. Okay. So go for Q0 and Q4. Okay. So I just delete this set. I just going it for Q4. Okay. So Q4 here is Q7 and Q5. So Q7, again, you have to again fully check the set. So for Q1 here, the set here is S2. For Q7 here, the set here is S2. So A, it is going towards the same set. So don't worry about this. On B, it is going towards the set 2 here. So there is no problem here. So it means that Q0 and Q4 are equivalent and hence can be placed in a similar set. In the same way, now you have to check Q0 and Q6 also. Okay, so again I'm checking Q0 and Q6. So Q6 and here is Q2 star. Okay, so with the star I know that it will go to a different set. Okay, so if I just check it, Q0 on it is going towards Q1. So Q1 here is a set 2. Q6 here is a set 1. Okay, so there this is again a different set. So you do not have to check B. It is already a different set here. So it means that Q0 is not equivalent to Q6. Okay. Himanshu, if we have time and the time persist, we definitely be studying about the cellular automata. But evolutionary algorithm is not a part of this course. Okay. So there is an application of automata in cellular. I will tell you if we have time. Because I think we are running very slow on the course. We have to just steady up. Okay. So I think I am just, I am solving very much question because I just want you to understand everything. So that is why I'm solving more questions and giving you more questions in tubes also. Okay. So if we have time, we will absolutely study cellular automata also. So for Q0 now I know that Q0 is not equal to Q6. So I can't place Q0. So it means that I have to create a new set where there will be a Q6. Okay. So again, you cannot combine this into another set. Keep in mind only the set that we are talking about, that I'm talking about the set 1. If Q6 is not equivalent to this set, it will be placed in a different set. You do not think about combining it with this set. So in the previous one also, we haven't combined it because we are just talking about this S1 here in the previous one. And there are two sets are formed. Okay, so if you remember it, two sets like Q0 and Q1, and these two sets are both opened. Okay, so for this opening, I just tried to put here or here, but here I am talking about only one set, and now the elements of this sets are all finished. So that is why I have closed this set. You cannot think about that I have to add this Q6 by checking the equivalence with this Q1 and Q7. Keep in mind, just when you're talking about one set, you just talk about this step set. You do not merge this set with any other set. Okay. So now you have to check the equivalence of Q1 and Q7. Okay. So again, Q1 and Q7 is written here. Okay. So again, now the sets are changed because there are four sets. So Q6 is in set one. It's on set one. Okay. So Q2 is also in set one, set four, and Q2 is also in set four. So they are both going to same set on getting a input. So I don't think that they are not equivalent. They are equivalent because there is nothing wrong with it. They are going towards a similar set. So it means that I cannot differentiate. I cannot break these two. So that's Q1 and Q7 will be similar here because they are equivalent. In the same way, Q5 and Q2, you do not have to worry about these set because they are single element set. So don't just touch them. Write those single set as it is. This is the algorithm here. Now we have only one or two sets that we have to break. We just try to break this set. So our main goal, when there are two elements, more than one element in the set, we try to break them. Okay. So keep in mind that our goal is to, if there is a couple in the set, we just want to break those. Okay. So for Q0 and Q4, if you just check it, Q0 and Q4. Q0 is Q1 and Q5, Q1 and Q5, Q4 is Q7 and Q5. Okay, now the set here are again changed for three equivalent state. Here this is set 1, set 2, set 3, set 4 and set 5. Okay, so Q1 is going towards the set 3 and Q7 also belongs to set 3, so they are one and the same. And Q5 belongs to Q4 and Q4. They are going towards the same set on A and B. So it means that I cannot differentiate with between these two sets. So they are equivalent set. So I'm just again placing it with that. Okay. So Q6. Now I just try to break this Q1 and Q7. So Q1 and Q7 again will be Q6, Q2. Q6, Q2. So I think they are just, because the number of states are same, they cannot be broken. If you again check it, Q6 is set 2, set 2, and Q2 is set 5 and set 5. Okay. So again, on getting input of A and B, so they are again going on the same set. So it means that I cannot differentiate between Q1 and Q7 as well. And you do not need to worry about these single element set. You just place it as it is. So Q6, Q5 and Q2 are placed as it is. If you see now, two equivalent result and three equivalent result are similar. So whenever the two equivalent state are equal to the three equivalent state, any equivalent state, if I just say, whenever n equivalent state is equal to n plus one equivalent state, it means that you have to stop this algorithm. Okay, so Q0, Q4, Q6, Q1, Q7, Q5, and Q2. We get the same result. It means that we have minimized enough. Now there is no further minimization. Okay, so now if I just, now you can. Okay, so there are two ways to replace this. Okay, so if in the previous table here, if you take this table, if I just can. So one way is to just write wherever there is a Q0. Now these two states have to be combined as Q0, Q4. Wherever there is Q4, you will write their Q0. Okay, in the same way, wherever there is Q1, write Q7, or just give these two states a different name. Okay, so I just name it as S and I just name the state as W. Okay, so now in the transition table, if I just see this, I can replace this as wherever there is Q0 and Q4 as a single state, I just replace that state by S here. So starting with this Q0, so I just replace it by S here. So Q1 is W. And one is Q5, so I do not need to worry about Q5. So Q1 here is W. So Q6 here is Q6. Q2 here is Q2. I do not need to worry about that also. So for Q2, it's Q0. So Q0 here becomes S, and Q2 becomes Q2 here. In the same way, check for Q4. So Q4 here is Q7. So Q7 becomes W, and Q5. So Q5 is Q5. Do not need to change that. Q6. So Q6 is Q6. Do not need to change that. So there is Q5 remaining. So Q5. So Q5 is Q5. Do not need to change that. Q2 is Q2, and Q6 is change. No, it is again the same thing. In the same way, check for Q6. Now Q6 is again the same. Q6 and Q4 is changed to S. Okay, in the same way, Q7, and Q7 belongs to Q6. So Q7 is again changed here. If you check it, it is W here. So W, and this will become your Q6, and Q2 is not changed. Okay, so you can design the automata by looking at this. It will be a complex one, but the number of states here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, rather than 8, okay? So 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 states. Okay, so only I think, okay, so there is, I think, you have to again check for the similar states also. So W and W is similar, so I just delete one state. I don't think. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 8 state automata is again changed to 6 state. Okay, so if you check it, there is something similar here. It has to be similar also here. Q1 and Q7. And Q0 and Q4. Okay, so Q4 also has to be similar. Here is S. So that is the mistake here. Okay, so Q4, if you check it, is S here. So that is why. If you check it, so these are again same. You can delete this state. So 8 state automata is reduced to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 5 states. So I think you get the step algorithm here. If you just try to do this question, this is a fairly basic question and it does not take very much of your time. So this is again a very good question, and it also came in the competitive exam of GATE. So I think it is GATE 2005 or 2006 question. Okay, so just try it. I think you can easily do this. Just keep in mind that do not forget to check the first step. Okay, so just try it. I think take 2 or 3 minutes, you can easily solve this. Yes, Amit and Manan, you are right. I just made a mistake here, so that is why I corrected. Remember the steps and try it. So I think more question you will do, the more you will get. Okay, so if anybody has tried it, okay, so you do not have to again draw the transition table here. If you directly want to do it, you can also. If I just show you that, you know that the number of states here are Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay, so you check the first step that all the states are reachable from it. So Q0 to Q1 I can be reached, Q0 to Q2 is also reachable, but Q3 is not reachable. So just forget about this state, I do not need it because it is not reachable, so what's the point in that? Okay, so there are only exactly three states. In these three states, the final one is Q1 and Q2, and the non-final one is Q0. Okay, so if you want to check it, you can again go with this. Okay, so this is fairly similar question, and it only, I think it will only follow one or two equivalent thing. Okay, so if it will go towards the two equivalent thing, it means that it cannot be minimized. Okay, so if it will go towards the two equivalent thing, but I think it, okay, so just we will see them. Okay, so don't worry about it. Okay, so again, this Q0 I cannot do about it, this Q0, because this is a single element set here, so you cannot do anything about it. Okay, so only I have to break these two. So Q1 and Q2. Okay, so if you check it, again, this is a very simple thing. You can, without any transition table, you can again check it. Okay, so you have to check it, Q1 on A and Q2 on A. So Q1 on A is going towards Q2. Q2 on A is going towards Q1. So Q1 and Q2 belongs to the same set, that is set 2. So on A, you cannot differentiate between them, so it is equivalent. So check for B, Q1 on B is staying at Q1. Q1 on B is staying at Q1 in the same way. If I just write this Q1 and Q2, Q1 on B is staying at Q1 in the same way. Q2 on B is staying at Q2. It means that this is your set 2 and this is your set 2. Again, it means that they are both equivalent in nature. Okay, so it means that these states cannot be separated because Q1 is equal to Q1. Okay, so it can be written like this. Now this set will become your complete state. Okay, so these will become your complete set like this. So if you just draw this automata, you can easily draw this also. Okay, so it will be like this, Q0 on E, it's going towards Q1, Q2 on Q1, Q2 on B is staying at Q1, Q2. So for B, I think it's like that. Okay, so if you just again draw the transition table, you can check it from there also. So you just have to replace Q1. I think this will be your, because both of these are defined here, and this is just starting with the, I think it is just what it is doing, A. So it is not worry about A, it just worry about A can be accepted, 2 A's can be accepted, and 1, 2, 3 A's can also be accepted. So after that, any number of A's can be accepted, I think. Okay, so if I do this, and after it, any number of A's, I do not need to worry about B. That is the correct automata. Okay, again, you can go with the a table here. Don't worry about that. I think you get this. If you are able to solve this again, this question was asked in, I think, in the GATE 2005. So if you see that these are very fairly basic questions, and again if you are doing automata, this is very easy to do, and the questions are not gonna be very complex. Okay, so they are very easy questions, and if you are attempting high level examinations, you can again very easily do this also. So again, in the PPT, there are another questions also. So for your practice, these questions are given. You should try it at home. If you are not able to solve anything, you just tell me, I will solve your doubt. In the same way, another question set will also be there in the tutorial 3. So don't worry about that. We will do plenty of questions regarding this minimization. Okay. So after our next topic is a very simple topic, and that is your epsilon NFA. I think you have a basic introduction of epsilon NFA in the NFA part. Okay, so I have given you the usage of epsilon. I have also told you that NFA can have epsilon moves. Okay, so there is some basic introduction that I have given you in the NFA part also. So NFA can contain epsilon and epsilon moves, and that NFA which contains epsilon moves is specifically called as a epsilon NFA. Okay, so its transition function is different than the other NFA and DFA. If you remember, DFA and NFA definitions are very similar. Okay, so DFA and only NFA. So DFA, it contains Q input alphabet. DFA and NFA, both these contain transition symbol Q naught and your final state. Okay, so the transition symbol of Q naught DFA is it like this, and the transition of NFA is like this. Okay, so if you remember this, it goes to the power set of Q. Okay. Now in this, again, the everything is similar, just the transition symbol of NFA is changed. Okay, so all the sets are similar, only the transition here is, it is like this, union of epsilon goes to 2^2. Okay, so it is just saying that if your input alphabet at a particular time is AB, so there can be a epsilon, a union of epsilon in the move also. Okay, so if I just take it like this, AB, a union epsilon. Okay, so it means union means that it can be AB, the set now becomes larger. In this set, epsilon move is also included. So it means Q into AB or epsilon belongs to a 2^2 Q power set. It means it basically means that any automata from a quite Q node can go to any other state by following epsilon move. So epsilon move is absolutely nothing. It means that there is no kind of input. You can directly move from Q0 to Q1 without doing anything, because this is a null string. So it means we are not inputting anything. So that is the beauty of this epsilon NFA. But this is quite a confusing one. We do not want this epsilon NFA, and basically we do not use this epsilon NFA in anything practical here. So basically they are again used for the union operator. If you remember that, if you want to combine two different automata, what you do, you just draw a Q naught state in the starting and write a epsilon here. So if it is a automata that accept odd strings, and this is automata that accepts even string. Okay, so for a NFA, you can combine by using this. So that is the only use of an epsilon NFA. Again, if you remember the definition that I have told you, that a DFA and NFA are equivalent in power. So there is no one that is more powerful. So by adding another thing called epsilon NFA, this is again equivalent in power. The expressive power of by adding epsilon is not improved or increased. It is one and the same thing. So it means if they are same in power, it means epsilon NFA can also be converted into a basic NFA. So there is no kind of worry about it. So every NFA can also be converted into epsilon NFA. So what you have to do, you just have to add a epsilon move. So epsilon move can be added anywhere because it doesn't carry any overhead. You just have to, if you have drawn a particular NFA, just take a state and just draw a epsilon move here. So that becomes your epsilon NFA. So there is no particular need of it, but adding a epsilon does not increase the power of your automata. So they are one and the same in the same way. So keep in mind DFA, NFA and epsilon NFA are equivalent in power. No one is powerful than this. So they can be interchangeable. They can be converted to each other. So the power is similar. Keep in mind. Okay. So they are equivalent to each other. Epsilon NFA can be converted to NFA and NFA can be converted to DFA. So all of these except only one thing, that is called your regular languages. So I will talk about more when I come to this topic. Okay. So by adding epsilon, there is no kind of other language that I am accepting. Okay. So this is again the transition symbol of epsilon, and it is again saying on getting an input of input alphabet is defined here. It is saying that input union epsilon. So this is epsilon not e here. Okay. So I have shown you the union set. I think you have understood it. Okay. So all the things are similar. All the things. Be it set of states, be it input alphabet, be it the starting state, final state, only the transition symbol. And in that transition symbol, only one thing is added here. Okay. So the power set is again the similar. Okay. So if you see this, there is a more important point that epsilon NFA add a convenient feature that they bring us nothing new. Okay. So keep in mind that they bring us nothing new. They do not extend the class of language. Okay. So the NFA and DFA accept the class of language called your regular language. Okay. So adding a epsilon doesn't extend the class of language. Again, epsilon NFA only accept regular language. So there is nothing new, but just it in the, if you see the union function is a little bit of application of this epsilon NFA. Okay. So these transitions are done spontaneously without looking at the input string, a convenience at time, but still only regular language are accepted. Okay. So if you have the example of this epsilon NFA is something like this. If you see on A, it is going towards, on getting an input of 0, it is going towards E, and on getting an input of B, it is going towards 1, it's going towards B. Okay. So epsilon on A is not defined. That is why it is written as a dead configuration. Okay. In the same way, you can see this E here. Okay, so on E, getting epsilon wherever you are going, B as well as E. So you can combine this state and write it like that. So this is a transition table related to the state transition diagram of epsilon NFA. Okay. So now the only point that we have to keep in mind, that we will try again to convert this epsilon NFA to NFA. Okay. So for that, we need something called the closure of states. Okay. So how to calculate a closure that is denoted by the CL of A. Okay. So if you see that all the states that are reachable by using the epsilon move, all the states are reachable that should be included. Okay. So if you see the closure of A here. Okay. So only without getting any input, if I just write a closure of A, only I can reach A here. Okay. So there is no other path that I can follow, but if you see the closure of E here, okay, so the closure of E here on getting an input of epsilon, where I can go, the C is already there. You can get E, the closure of something is already included in the set. So just keep in mind the closure of A is always A, and the closure of E is always included in the set. Okay. So without getting any input, you are always standing at a state. Okay. So keep, that is why it is right. So epsilon closure of E here is, you can again go towards the state E. E is already in the set. After that, on getting an input of epsilon, it can go towards B. On getting an input of epsilon, it can go towards a C here. Okay. So another one will be on getting an input of epsilon from E, it can go to B. And on getting an input of closure of epsilon, it can go towards D here. Okay. So these are the states that are reachable after getting a input as epsilon. Okay. So if you have to do this conversion, just keep in mind there is something called a epsilon closure. Okay. So if I find epsilon closure of B here. So if keep in mind, epsilon closure of B here is already B will be included in the set. After that, B is going towards D. Okay, so D is also in the set, and now there is no other state. Okay, so the epsilon closure of B is B and D. Okay, so keep in mind the closure is just whenever you receive a epsilon, which states are reachable. Okay, so if I just say E, getting a epsilon here, you can go towards B as well as C as well as D. So that is why the closure here is a bigger. So again, this is the steps to convert the epsilon NFA to NFA. So again, I will get back to it. If I just do one question, and it will be more clearer to you. So in this question, just you have to follow something that the algorithm has written like this. Okay, so keep in mind something called a epsilon closure followed by the input and followed by again the epsilon closure. So these three are the main steps that will occur in your automata here if you want to convert any epsilon NFA to a simple NFA. Okay, so how to convert it, just remember these three things that are given in the algorithm. Epsilon closure, so this is epsilon closure, so that the closure that I have written, so I just denote it by this epsilon closure. So epsilon closure, after that input, after that epsilon. I will tell you what is the meaning of this. Okay, so now I will just draw NFA transition table directly. So just go with this. There is A, B and C are the number of states, and I have to convert it into a 0 and 1. Okay, so there will be no epsilon in NFA, there will be no epsilon. So I just convert it into a 0 and 1. So I'm directly going in. So from A, take this. From A, take epsilon closure after input is here is zero. Okay. So whatever the result here, take a zero of it. Whatever the result here, take a epsilon closure again. Okay. So what I tell you, what do I mean? Okay. So A, from A, where can you reach by taking epsilon here? So from A, you can reach to B state. A is already there, so epsilon closure A is always possible. So after that, you can also go towards B. If you see A from B, you can also go from B to C, you can also go. So there are three states in this epsilon. Okay, so now on getting an input of 0, you have to define these states also. Okay, 0 0. Now A on getting an input of 0 is staying at A. B on getting an input of 0 is not defined, so it is just finished. This is our dead configuration. C on getting an input of 0 is going towards a state called C here. Okay, C here. Okay, now in the end step, you again have to take a closure. So the closure of epsilon closure of A is, you have already taken it, that is A, B, C. Now the epsilon closure of C is, I think, only C. It is not getting an input of epsilon, so there is no one there. Okay, so in this state, the states are for this NFA are A, comma B, comma C, comma D. Okay, so just keep in mind that this formula you have to follow. This is the only algorithm. Okay, so now for A, you again check the epsilon closure. So for A, the epsilon closure is A to B can, A is always there. The epsilon closure of A will always be A. After that, B and C, okay, B and C can be reached. After the input here is 1, so check for the input of 1 on everyone. So getting an input of 1 on A, it is not defined here. So this is a dead state. After that, B, it is getting here at B. After getting a C, it is saying on getting an input of 1, it is staying at C. Okay, so I think you got it now. Now the third step is again epsilon closure. So epsilon closure of phi is nothing, so this is dead state. Epsilon closure of B, so B is always there. So from B, you can reach by getting epsilon input, you can go towards C. So C is again there. Again, there is no one. After that, epsilon closure of C is C itself. there is no one there again. So you can draw it like this: B, C, and D are the number of state that you reached. In the same way, check for B also. So again, the same procedure has to be followed. The epsilon closure of B, from B, by getting an epsilon input, you can reach C here. So B is again, epsilon closure of anything is the set itself always. So B is already there and C there. C is also there. After that, getting an input of 0 here. So what is 0? Check for 0 here. For B, 0 is not defined, so this is a dead configuration. For C, it is C. After that, take a epsilon closure of this. So epsilon closure of dead configuration, nothing. In the same way, epsilon closure of C, is C itself? No, it is not going towards any state after getting an input of epsilon. Okay, so the result here is C only. In the same way, check. I think you understand what I am following here. So now check for 1. The epsilon closure of B here is B and C. On getting an input of 1, B is staying at 1. In the same way, C is also staying at 1. Okay, after it, the epsilon closure of B is BC and C is C itself. So if you combine this into a set, it will become B, comma C. Okay. So in the same way, check for C also. C, take a epsilon closure. So epsilon closure of C, here is C itself. So there is nothing on C, that there is no input of epsilon here. So C itself, after that you take a input of 0. So getting an input of 0, it is staying at C. After that, getting an input of epsilon closure again, take epsilon closure of C, it is again C. So the result here is C here. In the same way, again take epsilon closure of C, it is C itself. After that, take input, that is 1. Again on 1, it is staying at C. After again, take the epsilon, so it is again C. So this is your NFA for the resulting here. So if you just draw it, okay, so if I just draw it, it will be like this. So it seems a little bit of difficult here. So A state, I think it is the starting state, and the final state is C. So keep in mind the final state here is also C. Okay, so in getting an input of B, it is going towards A, it is going towards B also, it is going towards C also. Going towards, if I just C also, so it is going towards C also. On getting input of 0, it is going towards D also. If I just do this,
sir, in the question, D was not there actually.
Oh, that is correct. I just wrong. Yes, sorry for that. D is not a state. Okay. So if I just do this, okay. So why I do not know why I have written D. Okay. So now on getting input of 0, it is going towards A, B, and C. So that is it. On getting input of 1, it is going towards B. So it means that 1, comma, and C. So here will be a comma. Now on B, it is going towards 0. B, it is going towards C. And on 1, it is going towards B as well as on C. Okay, in the same way, C is just a self loop. Okay, so the final state is C. So I just do a double concentric circle. Okay, so this will be the solution of your equivalent NFA. So you don't know about this, that NFA, on getting an input, it can go to multiple states. Okay, so for 0, it is going towards A state, B state, and C state. So it can go. There is no problem regarding that. If you check the solution also, I think it will be similar, kind of a similar. Sure, I think that is similar. Okay. So again, try for this question also. In the next class, we will again discuss some 2 or more question for this epsilon NFA. I think our fun part is finished here. That finite automata without output is completed. So hopefully on Monday we will try and start with that finite automata with output, that is your Moore and Mallet machines. So thank you for listening, and you can tune in your next lecture.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, yes, please ask.
So, sir, basically, like when we were taking this epsilon, closure of A, that means ki hum log A se kaun se states pe ja sakte hain ki provided we are given only the input of epsilon, right?
Yes.
All
yes.
The possible states.
Yes, yes.
Is,
yes.
That's the reason we got A, B, and C.
Yes, yes.
Okay, sir.
A is, again, if you are taking a closure of A, A will always be in the same way if you are taking an epsilon closure of B. So again, B, you can again reach B without getting anything. Okay.
Okay, sir, got it.